The choice between Python and JavaScript is not only about picking a language, it's about the direction you want to take your career. It's about the type of project that you want to build. It's also about who you are. So, Python or JavaScript, which should you choose? First, what do the languages have in common? Python and JavaScript are both dynamically typed, interpreted scripting languages. They both have a wide range of uses. Python is great for data science and machine learning. JavaScript is essential for web development. Both are very useful, and you might want to pursue both, but that's just the surface. What are these languages' unique features, applications, and communities? What is their philosophy and purpose? And what do the statistics say about the difference between the two? Let's start with Python. Guido van Rossum began working on Python in the late 1980s. He wanted to create a language that focused on readability and simplicity. Python, introduced in 1991, embodies this philosophy. Its code tries to be as easy to understand as possible, and its syntax is elegant and simple. Python focuses on readability, which is why it uses indentation to define code blocks, rather than curly braces or keywords. This design choice isn't just about making programming easier for beginners. It enables developers to focus on solving problems. They don't need to decipher the syntax. Python's philosophy is expressed in the Zen of Python. It promotes simplicity, asserting, amongst other things, that readability counts. Moreover, Python also aims to be batteries included. It provides a wide range of functionalities without needing to install more. But how does this philosophy translate into real-world applications? Well, we'll explore that later. First, let's look at JavaScript's story. JavaScript's journey began in 1995. Brendan Eich designed it at Netscape. The goal was simple: to make web pages interactive. As the web matured, so did JavaScript's scope and capabilities. JavaScript's syntax offers greater flexibility, but comes with a steeper learning curve. Its roots in web development have shaped a language that can be both powerful and intricate, and frankly, occasionally infuriating. With the introduction of Node.js in 2009, JavaScript transcended its client-side limitations. It became a full-stack powerhouse capable of handling both front-end and back-end development. How did a client-side scripting language become so dominant? What does this tell us about JavaScript's adaptability and versatility? Well, we'll explore that later when we discuss application areas and ecosystems. First, the learning curve. The learning curve for both languages reflects their syntax and stylistic choices. Python's clear and concise syntax makes it an appealing first language. It promotes a smoother learning curve that gently introduces programming concepts. JavaScript's dynamic nature and broad usage present a daunting labyrinth of concepts. Its ubiquity across client and server-side programming offers a unique opportunity, but this comes with its own challenges. Each language has carved out distinctive niches. Let's explore each language's preferred domains. What are Python's primary use cases? Well, thanks to the Django and Flask frameworks, Python is suitable for server-side web applications. Python's readability and concise syntax make it ideal for automation scripts. Finally, Python's ecosystem includes the NumPy and Pandas libraries, which allow you to manipulate data. Matplotlib provides data visualization. Scikit allows you to run data analysis. TensorFlow and PyTorch allow machine learning. In short, Python is designed primarily for solving problems. What about JavaScript? JavaScript's role has evolved significantly since its inception. JavaScript's primary use case still is front-end development. The dominant library here is React. However, JavaScript is also used in back-end development, thanks to Node.js. Finally, React Native leverages JavaScript to develop native mobile apps. Electron allows developers to create desktop apps. So, which language is for you? What should you learn? Well, before we go into that, what do the statistics say about the different programming languages? Let's take a look at the Stack Overflow Developer Survey. JavaScript is the most used programming language with 63% of respondents. Python has a very respectable 49%. The main lesson to be learned here is not just JavaScript's dominance, but also that an important proportion of developers probably use both. If we look at the opinions developers have of the languages, JavaScript is the most desired at 40%. Python is slightly less desired, but is significantly more admired at 65% versus JavaScript's 58%. However, this picture is slightly muddled by TypeScript, which is slightly less desired again, but significantly more admired at 71%. And if we look at median salaries, we see that JavaScript has the lowest at $75,000, then TypeScript at $77,000, and Python at $78,000. Now, let's look at the different application domains. Let's draw a chart to answer two questions. What is the level of abstraction required? Is the application very practical or is it very theoretical? And what is the primary audience? How wide is it? Is it for personal use or mass market use? Because the choice between Python and JavaScript is about more than technicalities. It's about finding a language that resonates with your way of thinking. Let's explore what kind of person might find a natural affinity with each language. And let's use these axes. Who might lean towards Python? Well, there's the problem solver. If you like understanding the world and solving complex problems, Python might be for you. It's used extensively in data science, in machine learning, and in scientific computing. Head that way, and you'll be at the forefront of innovation. Here we have a high level of abstraction, but a limited audience. Then there's the pragmatic doer. If you want to automate tiresome tasks, Python might well be for you. Python's syntax and philosophy make it an excellent fit if you value getting things done. Here we have a very low level of abstraction, but an even more limited audience. Now, who might learn towards JavaScript? Well, there's the creative technologist. Do you love bringing ideas to life? If you love visuals and interactivity, JavaScript might be a good fit. Developing with browsers provides immediate results and a satisfying feedback loop. Then there's the full stack visionary. JavaScript might be a good fit if you want to build full stack web apps from the product up. This particularly appeals to visionaries who see projects through from concept to completion. Then there's the innovator and trendsetter. JavaScript is at the heart of many modern web technologies and frameworks. If you're an early adopter, JavaScript might be a good fit. JavaScript's ever-evolving ecosystem offers a playground for innovation and experimentation. In all these three cases, we have a middle-of-the-road level of abstraction, but a very large and even mass-market audience. Choosing between Python and JavaScript depends on who you are and what you want to do. Python is for those who like clear, efficient code and tackling tough problems with data. JavaScript is for those who like interactivity and showing their work. Now, we've examined their origins, philosophies, and uses. Both Python and JavaScript open doors to impact technology. But what is the best way to pick them up? Well, I have two websites that I use. The first is called Exercism. It guides you through the basics when you're discovering a language through a series of exercises. Once you're past that initial learning stage, I recommend CodeCrafters. The website allows you to build versions of real-life tools like Redis and SQLite and more. It has tracks in Python and JavaScript. It isn't suitable for beginners, and it isn't free, but it's perfect if you want to create advanced projects that you can show off in your dev portfolio. I've provided a link for both websites in the description and comments, and in the meantime, I'll see you in the next video.